Vreemdfront made a study of the proportional voting system in 94. We went abroad to do that. How does it work? And the result came that normally in a proportional voting system, there's about 10 parties in the end after an election. If you look at Germany, for example, some parties call themselves parties of interest, like the Greens or some of the Christian parties. And we came back and recommended to our party that we become a party, as we say, of interest, focusing on a certain niche market, and then be the best champion of that niche market. And once you're in parliament, then you look at alliances where you can sort of get what you want in that. Well, at the moment, we're focusing very strongly on the whole question of people voting abroad. But I think that's just a symbol of the rights of people, the rights in the Constitution. There's no guarantee that people abroad will vote necessarily for the Freedom Front Plus. We hope they will. But the principle behind it, that the Constitution is there, the rights in the Constitution must be protected, and that the ANC cannot be arrogantly bully you. So broadly we're fighting that. And then surely South Africa is a diverse country. And to get the balance right between unity and diversity, I think, is the secret recipe for the future. If you overemphasize unity, minorities feel threatened and discriminated against. If you overemphasize the diversity, it may end up with apartheid and racism and discrimination. Well, without doubt, crime is the most important one at the moment because of the effect on the whole of the country. If we can solve that one, immediately a lot of things will come into place. People will turn from abroad if it's a crime-free environment, and surely it will have the rest. Economic growth and the rest will come after that. So surely that's the first one. Because of the way we see ourselves, we also emphasize the diversity issue. Meaning South Africa, diversity issue, language as such, mother tongue education is important. And we really believe that if we don't address that, we're not going to get harmony and balance in South Africa and give everyone opportunity. I think we can govern better. And I think we've proved that more or less where we're in government. For example, in Cape Town, where the speaker is from the Freedom Front Plus, just by looking at merit, for example, merit is so important, merit and merit alone, and then surely be sensitive for people. On corruption, for example, it's unbelievable the way at the moment things are going in South Africa, and we really believe you need expertise. Let's use the expertise that we have in South Africa and see transformation in that sense, and not only as racial quotas all the time and then going deeper and deeper into trouble. On the long run, without doubt, that's the future. What happened here is because of the struggle and because of the past, the ANC got this artificial unity. If you really study them, it's a very artificial party that got the only cement keeping together was the struggle and the struggle history. And with COPE now, we see it for the first time how they struggle to keep it together. So I predict within a few elections, maybe next already, we'll get to that situation where the ANC will not get 50% and will be under 50%. And then for the first time, the proportional system will start kicking in and all these things will start operating. No, Afrikaans. Okay. The moment you go for the racial issues, there's no way you can argue that. There's no such thing as racial self-determination or white supremacy, that type of thing. That's nonsense and that's out. There's no way. Okay, but surely you've got cultural rights and you've got group rights, and that's attached to your identity and your culture, and that's part of the world, yeah. Well, we're trying in a sense, but I must, at the moment, because of lack of money and those things, surely you've got priorities to say where's the best results for the effort you put in. Yeah, sure. Well, of course, there's no way you're going to say you're in or out. You're not even willing to say English guy is not welcome. So in the end, it's a natural trend all over the world that people then tend to concentrate in certain areas. You get America at Chinatown. Nobody said this is a homeland for Chinese people in Los Angeles. But it seems that people in the end voluntarily go to certain areas because it empowers them in a certain sense. It gives them some protection. And so surely now they can argue maybe for a school in their own language in that area. It's very difficult, for example, to argue that in Natal, where Afrikaans is the third biggest language, but it's a 1% language. So there's no way you can put up a fight there. But if you go to the Northern Cape and 70% speak Afrikaans, why must the number plates there be in English? It doesn't make sense. Well, Afrikaans nation, we're part of Africa now for 350 years. We're not going anywhere. My children will be here. In 50 years, they'll still be here. The ANC won't be here anymore. Maybe Freedom Front won't be here, but there will still be Afrikaans speakers here. And surely the question is there a place in the sun for them in Africa? Because I'm an African, I'm not a European. I studied abroad, but my roots are here and I'm part of this country. And I think I can make a contribution to make it a better country for all. At the moment, I feel marginalized and being pushed aside. My skills are not asked for. Affirmative action pushed me aside. My language, I get the perception I'm pushed aside. That angers people. I think the moment in 10 years' time, we'll get the balance right and say, we need everyone. Well, in South Africa, you've got a choice. If you're not happy with what's going on, you may immigrate. But if you decide to stay, as Freedom Front decided to stay and I decided to stay, then surely you must get involved. There's no way staying behind and then moan and groan all the time and doesn't do anything about it. Do something about it. The first thing, vote for the party closest to your values and let them carry those values into government. Surely that's positive and that's making a contribution.